Welcome back to Rachel's Rocks. No, I'm kidding. I was going to try and do an intro that was fun, but that was ridiculous. I apologize. Anyway, I have a nice rock here. It's a Lake Superior stone, and it's kind of like a red stone, and it's kind of flat. And if I painted it white and added sparkle, it would resemble a Santorini almost, except for it's not as flat. So it's kind of squarish. I'm going to paint a beautiful background on it. This is just kind of to show you some of the things that you can do to the backgrounds of your stones to dress them up a little bit. So I've decided to paint it black, let it dry, two coats, and I'm using some metallic watercolor from Etsy, from Yuli Watercolors, the best watercolors I've ever seen in my entire life. All the little crevices and cracks and pits, all those little things in the stone are going to be accented by the pigments that just kind of settle there. And it looks amazing. It almost gives it like dimensions and depth and beauty. And I'm going to cover this with resin. I'm just kind of doing a rainbow. So all you do is you activate the watercolor with water, and it kind of like simmers and sparkles, and someone called it sizzling, and it does. It sizzles. That glitter like sizzles in all the little crevices. I absolutely love it. And you'd be really surprised at what it will do to your rocks. So I like to sponge. First I use a paintbrush, but then I sponge the paint, the black background on, because I want to make sure that there's no brush strokes, because just like the pigments settle into all the cracks and crevices here, it settles into paint brush strokes as well. So I use a sponge, get rid of all my brush strokes, and then I let it dry. You can still see it sizzling. It's like my favorite part. But then I resined it. So this has been resined. It's been dried for about 20 hours because I got busy. And it's nice and dry, ready for me to just use a simple little stencil that I cut out on my Cricut. I will leave a link to the Etsy shop where I bought this Cricut printout. It was super, super inexpensive, and it was like a digital download, and then I just upload it on my computer and put it through my Cricut. If anyone's familiar with a Cricut design space or a Cricut machine that can cut out stencils like this. So if you want to go quickly, you just want to worry about your background more. You don't want to worry about the whole artwork situation as much. Maybe you're not very creative, but you want a really pretty background to start with. This is one idea for you. So I'm not going to just stencil it on. I'm going to do a bunch of stuff with it. I don't like to use just a stencil, but if that's the only way that you feel comfortable making art, then by golly, you do that. Now, it kind of looks like I'm doing like a weird face on here, but I'm literally just trying to get like the outline of the snowflakes. If you guys want more Cricut videos, more Cricut stuff on rocks or canvas, let me know in the comments and I'll make like a different section for videos on Cricut stuff or stenciled stuff. Because you guys have seen in my over 230 videos that I don't use a stencil for everything. I do the best I can with it without using anything like that. But there's nothing wrong with that because you know what? I do own a Cricut. My husband got me one. I don't really know what to do with it besides cut out like cute little stencils that I can paint. Like I said, I don't do that very often. So this time I'm doing it because I'm just going to show you what the background is more important to me. The watercolor, the metallic watercolors always look nicer on a black background. That's when you get the most out of your metallic pigment is on top of that black background. So if you put it on a white stone, it might be glittery. It might look glittery and a little bit colorful in some places, but it doesn't stand out the way it does on a black background. So this is just one idea of a colorful background and a stencil. Like, I mean, this is pretty easy so far. The whole process that took a long time was the watercolor and then sealing it with resin, because it is sealed. Like, it looks like it's under glass now, and this stencil is going to come up off of that glass, and hopefully we can change this beautiful tree into something beautiful and amazing for Christmas decor. We'll see. We'll see. And I like circular things. You guys know this from my channel. I like things being in a circle. So this was in a circle and it attracted my eye. So I bought it. but yeah, I will link everybody to everything that I'm using here. The stencil. You can't just go out and buy this stencil. You would have to have someone like make it for you, or get the company to print one off, I think. I don't even know. It's not legal for me to like print this stencil off and sell it to you guys. It's not legal. I would get in trouble. So you would have to go purchase a Cricut. You would have to go purchase a stencil off of Etsy, just like this one. But in no means do you have to do that. I've had a couple of people tell me that I cost them way too much money. But honestly, I don't expect anyone to go out and buy a Cricut. I couldn't afford one, and my husband still got me one for our anniversary. So, I don't want anyone to think that they have to go out and buy the stuff that I'm using. And the metallic watercolors, I'm going to be selling more and more of it. I'm trying to perfect it. I've done a lot of research. I've been working on a lot of stuff. So I'm trying to perfect my watercolor before I sell more. I want to kind of find out what people think of the first set, but I know I've already improved in my watercolors. So I will be adding more, and I'm making more, and I've ordered more stuff, and I've spent more money to make better watercolors that I can offer in my Canadian Etsy shop, and hopefully make them affordable for everybody. So if you're in Canada, or if you're not in Canada, I still ship to the States. But if you're in Canada and you want to try out some metallic watercolors, I will be adding some more to my Etsy shop. I'm just adding some snow to my tree here. This is just a simple stencil. You can probably pause this and draw it out yourself. That's why I chose this one. Because it's, you know, they're intricate little snowflakes, but they don't have to be. It's been cut by a machine, so there's no way that my hands could make perfect little snowflakes like that. But you can definitely paint this whole picture right here. You can use a compass to make your circle, or even like a lid or a plate. Make your circle, put your tree in there, put some snow on the tree, outline it with gold like I'm doing now. Put some dots using a dotting tool to make those big snowflakes and stars on either side of the tree. And then underneath the tree, in the lower part of the circle, you do what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 snowflakes. That's all you got to do. And change the sizes of the snowflakes as you get up closer to the sides of the tree. And that's all you have to do. You can paint this pretty easily. And yeah, the only reason why I used a stencil was because I really just wanted to focus on the background of the stone, giving you guys ideas on what to do with the background. Now, I will be adding some different stuff to this so that it's a little bit more my own. And of course it's painted. It's not just a stencil. I'm adding to it, right? So, you know, it's still going to look beautiful when we're done. You can tell that I'm kind of iffy about the stencil thing. Wishy-washy. I feel like less of an artist if I use a stencil, but that's only because what other people have criticized in the past. So, like, I've seen it. I've seen it on artist groups on Facebook, and you know, people can be really nasty if they think that you're cheating being an artist. But as far as I'm concerned, use whatever tools you need to make something beautiful and make yourself proud. Use whatever you need to. Use whatever kinds of mixed media If you want to use crystals, you want to use watercolor metallics, you want to use gold, you do that. And that's what I do. So I'm only wishy-washy about the stencil thing because I know how people can get sometimes. But I've proven myself on this channel that I'm not a stencil user all the time. So I've outlined my tree. I've used a hunter green on the tree and then added a bright green and did some little hairs or wisps of bright green on the hunter green so that it just kind of makes it a little prettier. And then I outlined it with gold, of course. Now I will be adding some more watercolor, metallic watercolor to the snow. And it's like a holographic, kind of looks like a silver holographic paint. And it's absolutely beautiful and it sparkles just right. I'm going to be adding some little flatback crystals to the center of my snowflakes and the center of my little stars. I'm going to lengthen, I don't know what those are called, the little lines coming from the stars to make them look super shiny. I'm going to lengthen those on a bunch of the other stars. Can't even see the other stars right now, but I'm going to find them. And I did sponge over top of the stencil where the snow was supposed to be on the tree. So now I've just kind of made it up. Just kind of went over it myself and made it up. You're allowed to do that. You're allowed to do whatever you want. And yeah, I don't care what you do. If you need to use a stencil for your lettering, do it. Lettering stresses me out. And I will use a stencil whenever I get the chance. But if you see like a really cute stencil somewhere, say at Michael's or, and you think, oh, I'm not a real artist if I use a stencil. That's not true. Don't ever, ever think that ever, ever. So now I'm going to decorate the outside of this a little bit. I'm just putting some big gold dots, and I started at the top, bottom, left, right, and now I'm going in between those fairly big dot because what it's going to be is Christmas lights. So, and notice how I just keep like wiping my dots off and moving them into the place I want them to. Just wipe them off. Boop. That's what I love about resin because once it's cured, it's like a glass surface, so I can like just wipe off any mistakes that I make, and I do that all the time. All the time. So now I'm just going to take Christmas light colors. So any colors you want, but I'm going to choose some Christmas colors here, starting off with red. And I'm just doing like the shape of a bulb, like maybe like an old fashioned, bigger glass, clear glass Christmas bulb. Those ones make me feel happy inside. So I'm going to do each color. I'm going to paint it out with a paintbrush and then I'm going to sponge it down so it's a nice even layer of paint. A couple of them are going to need three coats using a sponge once they dry because, of course, I didn't start with a white background, right? I didn't make it easy for myself. So, yeah, I had to do a few coats of yellow, a few coats of orange, a few coats of red. But you guys know it's all worth it. It's all worth it. All this time that we take, it's all worth it. And so I'm just doing all the lights in one direction. And they're going to be nice and shiny. And it's just a cute Christmassy border to go along with our stencil. There was a little bit of room left on the rock that we could take up, so why not? I believe I have done Christmas lights like this around the border before, and I think it might have been a heart-shaped stone, but I could be wrong. But I will be sharing all of my Christmas tutorials on my Facebook page for everybody over the next couple of days, next couple of weeks. I have two more tutorials that are, one's finished, I just have to edit it and post it. It's going to be going up not today, because this one's up today, but it'll be going up in 2 days. And then I have another one, another Christmas one, that I think you guys are really going to like. I've had a lot of people ask me, for something specific, and I haven't done it yet. So that's what I'm going to work on. And I have a bunch of ideas. But if you have any more ideas for me, even for New Year's ideas, if you have anything that you want to see me paint, let me know in the comments of the video. And then I can check back and then write it down on a list and see where we can go from there. So you can see I've got like way too many coats that need to be done here. You can see right through all of these lights. It's brutal. You can see right through that. So yeah, you're probably going to be smart and do like a little white light bulb first, let that dry, and then do your color. That would be your best bet, or you're gonna have to wait layer after layer for all of these to dry. Now they're dry. And now I'm going to lighten them a little bit. So I used like a darker blue, and now I'm adding a lighter blue with a blending brush. And I'll leave in the description of this video a blending brush tutorial so that you can make sure you have, it's kind of like a sponge on a stick. It works like a littler sponge. It fits into smaller places and makes things a little bit easier for you. So on the purple, I'm doing a lighter purple. On the green, I'm doing a lighter green. And I'm just kind of going, keeping it to the inside. I'm not going right out to the edges. I'm just kind of trying to highlight the inside area. So you can see that there's still some darker green there. It's getting blurry. I apologize. It's not because of the wine that you're drinking. It's because my camera keeps going out of focus. So I've done that to all of them. I've lightened up the centers just a little bit, just a little bit. It makes them have a different glow. It doesn't make them so flat looking. And I'm going to be adding a little bloop of white too, to make them look like they're shiny. But they're simple little lights just outlined with gold. And then I'm going to outline them with black as well, to separate them from everything, from the background, from the gold, circle. Because some of these lights are sitting above that gold circle. So just put your little white bloops in once everything's dry. It just gives them that extra shine. They're going to be even more shiny once we hit them with another coat of resin. But I want them all to be shiny. I want the stars to be shiny. I want the snowflakes to be shiny. The snow. Everything has to be shiny in my Christmassy world. So I'm lengthening the tails. Can I call them tails? The lines. The shine on the stars. I need to make the shine longer. That's what I'm doing. Just making a couple of these dots into stars. And make sure you got two coats of white on your dots. And check your snowflakes. Make sure you can't see through your snowflakes too. I add a couple of dots to the snowflake in certain areas to kind of cover up some of the what I can see through, but it's not like you can't really tell right now. It's not really noticeable. So I'm just kind of adding some dots in some places. And also I had to scratch off some paint in some areas. I just use a little dotting tool and I scratch off some paint that wasn't supposed to be there because it bled through the stencil. But luckily it bled through the stencil on top of resin that has been cured, because like I said, it's like a glass surface. So I can just literally scratch off anything. If it's dry paint, scratch it off. If it's wet, just wipe it off with your hand and poof, it's gone. No mistakes were made, ever. You can restart this as many times as you want once you have a resined surface to work with. So I'm going to do some of that holographic sparkle just on the bottom of the snow. So hopefully you guys are able to recreate something like this, even though you don't have the stencil. It's a simple enough idea that we can all work with to make something beautiful. So you can see all the bits of snow just at the bottom is gonna be sparkling. Now I'm adding some Mod Podge to my stars. Just a little dot will do. And then I'm going to add my flatback crystals, just little Swarovski crystals, into my stars. And I'm going to also put them in the center of my snowflakes, like I said, because I just can't. They can't be naked. They can't be naked snowflakes. It's just not okay with me. So another little dot of Mod Podge. I use that as glue. I use that for multiple things at my desk. Very handy. Very, very handy. Make sure you let that glue dry and let all your paint dry. And then you can re-resin it, reseal it, and it's going to look fantabulous. But before I reseal it, or before I show you the resin reveal, I'm going to just show you a couple of more things that I've done just with the background. Just pay attention to the background. What I've done with some of my own handmade watercolors, metallic watercolors, and from Yuli on Etsy. And I will always leave the link for Yuli on Etsy because Jeannie has the absolute best, no matter what, the best watercolors I've ever seen in my life. And every Instagram video that she posts, I'm like mesmerized. It's just like, if it were food, my mouth would be watering. So I don't think it's normal for my mouth to water over watercolor paint. But it's just mesmerizing, and that kind of thing makes me happy. That kind of, her videos just hypnotize me. So I'm outlining. You can see that some of my light bulbs go over top of that gold circle. And that's okay, because I'm going to outline it. I'm going to separate it from that gold circle so that it looks like it's kind of sitting above it. And there you go. Ready to be resined again. So while it's being resined, this is what I've done with some of the backgrounds of my stones using metallic watercolors. Kind of like the snowflakes that I showed you a couple tutorials ago. Look at this. You can do so many things. You've seen me do the Seed of Life. You've seen me do Zentangle Dragonflies. You've seen me do all of these paw prints, dotted paw prints, the dial around the frame. You've seen me do that. I'm just using an easy way to blend beautiful colors in the background is watercolor. So if you're having trouble with blending, use watercolor. Look at this. This has got to be my favorite. It's absolutely gorgeous. It's been sitting for a long time. I don't even know what I'm going to paint on it yet. But I have a few. I have a few gems sitting here waiting to have something done with it. And I'm adding more of my buttons. I'm perfecting my buttons as well. They're a little sloppy, but there's going to be more paint buttons in my shop so that you can be creative with the background just like this. What do you think, guys? Is that beautiful or what? And yes, it's okay to use a stencil. Make it your own. Do something beautiful with it. I love you guys. I will be back very soon. Keep painting.